I am going to discuss safety and quality requirements for milk and milk products. Milk is a highly perishable commodity. All safety measures must be taken at all stages of its supply chain from farm to fork for its safety and quality. Because milk is a commodity is consumed by a vast population in the country, including children and also infants after certain age. Milk and milk products are susceptible to various physical, chemical and microbial contamination as well as adulteration during procurement, processing, preparation, storage and distribution. Now, let us see what are the common contaminants in milk. Lead, mercury, methyl mercury, arsenic, cadmium, aflatoxin M1, antibiotic residues, aldrin, DDT, ethione, caldrein, lindane, etcetera. These are the either crops contaminants or contaminants come from environment, farm level or during processing or preparation. Now, common adulterations are milk which are man-made or intentionally added to food. In case of milk, water, starch, urea, detergent, sugar, glucose, dextrose, vegetable fat, neutralizer, melamine, formalin, etcetera. Ghee and butter, vanaspati and margarine, paneer and khoa, starch, rabdi, blotting paper. Now, to eliminate these contaminants and adulterants and also to avoid any other contamination in milk and milk products, suitable measures to be taken for every stage of supply chain. Now let us see what are these steps. At farm level, there should be proper animal health care under supervision of veterinary doctor, because if animal is sick, so milk production from that type of animal should also be contaminated. The cleanliness of milk shed area is also important. It should be cleaned regularly with suitable cleaning agent like bleaching powder. Then milking is also important. It should be done after cleaning of udder of animal by potable water, and then wiping the udder with clean cloths and discarding foul milk, because foul milk may contain some fecal material and other contaminants. Use of clean and non-corrosive utensils, but especially stainless steels or a food grade plastic material may be used. There should be quick transfer of milk from production center to collection center. In every milk producing area, there are collection centers. So, this milk should be transferred to collection center not later than 4 hours of milking. Now, at procurement stage, there should be provision for bulk milk cooler, so that milk are stored in this cooler. There should be quick transfer of milk from the collection center to chilling centers. So, after collecting milk in the collection center, the milk are transferred to chilling centers, which are located maybe far away from the milk collection center. So, from milk collection center also, milk should be transferred to chilling center within 4 hours of collection of milk, and maintaining temperature as low as possible, maybe 4 to 5 degrees centigrade. Now, there should be some measures should be taken in milk chilling center also. There should be adequate facility for chilling and testing of raw milk. Because if raw milk are not tested, this milk may be contaminated or even adulterated. So, this should be tested before putting into chilling tanks. The temperature of chilling tanks should be maintained at 4 to 6 degrees centigrade. The storage of milk should be in the non-corrosive containers like stainless steel containers. There should be provision for insulated and specially designed vehicle for transportation of milk from chilling center or from collection center to dairy plant. Actually, for transportation of milk, the special purpose vehicles are available only for transporting milk. Maintenance of time and temperature, 4 to 5 degrees centigrade, I have already mentioned, and time should be as quick as possible, not later than 4 hours after collection of milk or from chilling center to processing plant. But if from chilling center to processing plant, time may be more, but temperature should be maintained 4 degree to 5 degrees centigrade throughout this transportation. Now, there should be some measures taken in milk processing plant or dairy plant. There should be raised platform installed for uploading of milk, because milk is coming to the milk center in a tanker. So, there should be a raised platform, and there should be facilities for testing of milk, like MBRT and other testing, so that if milk is not found suitable, it may be rejected. And there should be facility for hygienic handling and storage of raw milk. Temperature of storage of milk in the storage tank maintained 4 degrees centigrade or below until the raw milk is processed further. Then after storage, milk is pasteurized. Then immediately after pasteurization of milk, the milk shall be cooled to a temperature of 4 degrees centigrade or lower. The maximum temperature at which pasteurized milk can be stored shall not be more than 5 degrees centigrade. So, these are the important point for maintenance of temperature in the storage tank or in the milk supply chain. The plant shall be so constructed and machinery and equipment so designed and installed so as to permit easy cleaning and hygienic production. There should not be cross contamination of man and material in milk processing plant. And now coming to the drain, the other requirements. There should be efficient drainage system for liquid waste, because in milk processing area there should be milk with water, so another effluent. There should be efficient drainage system so that these waste are disposed, liquidity are disposed as quickly as possible and properly. Then there should be a periodically disposal of solid waste from the processing plant. Covered weight container should be provided suitably, and this should be placed suitably. There should be provision of ETP, effluent treatment plant, whenever and wherever it is necessary. The personal hygiene is also important for handling of milk and milk products. All workers should be free from any infectious or contagious diseases. All workers should wear clean clothes like aprons, foot and hand wires and hand gloves. They should wash hands and feet before every entry in the processing hall. They should refrain from bad habits like chewing, spitting, smoking, or rubbing their parts of bodies. They should remove all ornaments before entering the processing. All ornaments should be covered properly. Cleaning and sanitation is very important in the dairy plant. There should be all equipment and machinery should be cleaned and disinfected regularly as per standard operating procedures. And CIP means cleaning process should be in place wherever necessary. Wherever the machinery cannot be dismantled, there should be proper and efficient CIP available in milk processing plant. Machinery and equipment and containers come in contact with dairy products shall be cleaned and disinfected as per verified cleaning program. Cleaning chemicals should be handled properly and carefully, and they should be stored properly with identification to avoid contamination. Process control. There should be proper time and temperature control devices for machinery and equipments. For example, for pasteurization, the time temperature is 70 degrees centigrade for 15 seconds. So if temperature device is not proper or defective, this time temperature control cannot be done properly. If frozen product is used for preparation of any milk product, and if it is opened, this should not be stored back for future use. This should be used at a time. Proper smoke steam outlet should be provided in cooking section like chimney, etc. There should be in-process quality control done for every batch of production. Production should be supervised by a qualified technical person having dairy technology for dairy and milk and milk products. Then after processing and packing, it should be packed properly. Only food grade packing material should be used in dairy products. Wrapping and packing should be done under strict hygienic condition. The room for packing all milk and milk products should be sufficiently large and free from cross contamination. Wrapping and packing should be done immediately after processing. Wrapping and packing material shall not be reused. Storage, provision of pellets with non-absorbent materials like stainless steel or plastic should be used. Wooden pellets should not be used because it absorbs water. There should be separate storage for different dairy products like paneer, cheese, ghee, butter, etc. And temperature should be and humidity should be maintained. There should be cold storage facility wherever necessary. Food and non-food items should be stored separately with proper identification mark. Then pest control measure. There should be efficient pest and rodent control measures should be in place. For rodent control, there should be trap in the processing plant. Premises and plant should be kept in good repair to prevent excess. It is important that the pest and rodents should be denied entry, and there should be potential proper measure for elimination of potential breeding sites. Food materials stored in pest-proof containers and stacked above ground and away from wall to avoid contamination. Records of pesticide and insecticide maintained properly. Distribution of milk and milk products. All critical links in supply chain should be identified properly for proper traceability. Provision of cold chain is to be there wherever necessary. Containers and supply vehicle should be suitably designed especially for distribution of milk and milk products. Quality control management system. There should be in-house facility for testing of raw milk and milk products. Qualified chemists should be employed for chemical and microbiological testing. Traceability and recall procedure to be in place. If in-house facility is not available for testing of milk and milk product like chemical contaminants, it should be done from outside NABL accredited laboratory periodically, at least once in 6 months, as laid down under the regulations. Some tests for quality of raw and pasteurized milk. COB, that is clot on boiling test for protein coagulation and curdling. Alcohol test for stability of milk for sterilization, whether it is properly sterilized or not. This can be tested by alcohol testing. Acid test for detection of neutralizer yeast for neutralizing milk, lactic acid formation, etc. Preservative test, hydrogen peroxide test or formalin test is to be done. MBRT test for microbial load. MBRT test, that is methylene blue reduction. The methylene blue is added to milk, and if this blue color is not reduced within 5 hours, this indicates this is a good quality of milk. But if it is reduced within 5 hours, this is, or within 4 hours, this is bad quality or poor quality of milk, this milk should be rejected. There should be for phosphate test for pasteurization, whether milk is properly pasteurized or not. This can be tested by phosphate test. Phosphate is an enzyme. And now there are other standards for milk and milk products. For buffalo milk, it is 5 to 6 for milk fat, and minimum milk solid is 9%. Cow milk, 3 to 3.5%, and for milk solid, it is 8.5%. Goat meat, 3% milk fat, and milk solid 9%. Mixed milk, 4.5%. Milk fat and 8.5% milk solids. Paneer, there are two types of paneer. Normal paneer, maximum moisture should is 70%, and minimal milk fat content is 50%. For low fat paneer, maximum moisture is 70% and maximum fat is 15%. Cream. It shall be free from starch and other ingredients foreign to milk. Standards for following three categories of cream milk are: for low fat milk, minimum fat content is 25%, medium fat cream, minimum fat content 40%, and high fat content should be 60%. Butter should be free from animal or vegetable fat, mineral oils, rancidity, and added flavor. It shall conform to following standards. Maximum common salt 16%, moisture 80%, fat content maximum is 1.5%, and milk solid maximum 3%. And desi or cooking butter, maximum moisture content 76%. Ice cream or kulfi, there are three types of ice cream or kulfi. High fat kulfi, minimum TSS should be 36% and minimum fat 10%, minimum milk protein 3.5%. Medium fat, minimum TSS 30% and fat content 2.5 to 10%, and milk protein is 3.5%. Low fat, minimum TSS 26%, fat 2.5%, and milk protein 3%. Now coming to the microbial requirements, which is also very important for milk and milk products. For aerobic plate count and chloriform count, for pasteurized milk, acceptable limit is 30,000 and marginable acceptable limit is 50,000. Chloriform count should be absent in 0.1 ml. Pasteurized milk, aerobic plate count is 50,000 and marginally available acceptable limit is 75,000. Chloriform count acceptable limit is 10. Pasteurized butter, aerobic count 25,000, acceptable limit marginally acceptable 50,000. And chloriform count is absent in 1 gram, marginally acceptable 20 per gram. Infant milk, acceptable limit is 500, marginally acceptable limit 50,000. And chloriform count acceptable limit is absent in 0.1 gram. Ice cream and frozen desserts, acceptable limit 1 lakh per gram and marginally acceptable 2 lakhs per gram. supply from count 10 per gram and marginally acceptable 100 per gram. Staphylococcus aureus for pasteurized milk and yeast and mold count, pasteurized milk MBRT test, there should be no discoloration in 5 hours. Pasteurized cream, there is no standards. Pasteurized butter, it is 10 per gram acceptable limits and marginally acceptable limits 50 per gram. Yeast and mold count 20 per gram, marginally acceptable 50 per gram. Infant milk food, there should be absent, the staphylococcus absent in 0.1 gram, and also in yeast and mold count it should be absent in 0.1 gram. Ice cream and frozen desserts, the staphylococcus aureus maximum is 10 per gram and marginally acceptable 100 per gram. For E. coli, it is pasteurized milk absent in 0.1 ml, pasteurized cream absent in 0.1 gram, pasteurized butter absent in 0.1 gram, infant milk food absent in 0.1 gram, and ice cream and desserts absent in per gram. For salmonella, pasteurized milk absent in 25 ml, pasteurized cream absent in 25 gram, pasteurized butter, infant milk food, and ice cream and frozen desserts, all three cases it should be absent in 25 gram. Similarly, for other pathogens like Listeria monocytogenes and Bacillus aureus, for pasteurized milk, it should be absent in 25 ml. Pasteurized cream, it should be absent in 25 gram. Pasteurized butter, it should be absent in per gram. Infant milk food, it should be absent in 25 gram. And ice cream and dessert, it should be absent in 1 gram. And for infant milk, Bacillus aureus, it is 100, maximum limit is 100 per gram, and marginally limited 500 per gram. See, for metal contamination, lead for infant milk food, it is 0.2 ppm, arsenic, ice cream 0.1 ppm, infant milk substitute 0.05 ppm, ice cream 0.5 ppm, infant cadmium, infant milk substitute 0.01 ppm, mercury in all milk product it is 1 ppm, methyl mercury for one milk product is 0.25 ppm. Limit for some pesticide residues. Now limit for melamine, it is also contaminant. Recently FSA notified a limit for some foods. For powder infant formula, maximum limit for melamine is 1 ppm. Liquid infant formula is 0.1 ppm. And other milk product, it is 2.5 ppm. There are limit for pesticide residues. For aldrin, milk and milk products, 0.1 ppm fat basis. Caldrin for all milk products, 0.05 ppm. DDT for all milk products, 1.25 ppm. Lindane for milk, it is 0.01 ppm. Milk products, 0.2 ppm. And ethane, it is 0.5 ppm. With this, I conclude my presentation with a remark that all food business operators engaged in supply and production of milk and milk products should take all possible cares, safety measures, and products, those who are manufacturing of milk and milk products should ensure that all the milk products are manufactured as per standards laid down in the regulation, and they should conform to the contaminants and other parameters laid down in the regulations.